Honorable Speaker, sir, my esteemed colleagues in the 18th Lok Sabha, I stand here on behalf of my party. Pradhan, Mr. Prime Minister, Honorable Prime Minister, I would really request you, since you've been here for the better half of 1 hour, ye bhi sunte hue jaiye, sir, dariye mat. Dariye mat, sir, dariye mat. Do baar aage, sir. You came to my area twice during the campaign, sir. Aaj to sunte jaiye, sir. Never mind, my bad luck. Honorable Speaker, sir, Rahul. Sir, Honorable Speaker, sir, my esteemed colleagues in this newly constituted 18th Lok Sabha, I stand here on behalf of my party, the All India Trinamool Congress. Koi baat nahi, wo mere LOP hai. Wo mere LOP hai. Wo already mujhe sun chuke hai. Wo mere LOP hai. Honorable Speaker, sir, my esteemed colleagues in this 18th Lok Sabha, I stand here on behalf of my party, the All India Trinamool Congress, to speak on the Honorable President's address. The last time I stood here, sir, the last time I stood here, I was not allowed to speak. I was not allowed to speak. Aap logo ne... let me finish. Dimple, let me finish. Guys, ignore. Let me finish. And jisko jana hai, please jaiye, no problem. The last time I stood here, I was not allowed to speak. I was not allowed to speak. But the ruling party has paid a very heavy price for throttling the voice of one MP. मुझे बैठाने का चक्कर में जनता ने आपके 63 सदस्यों 63 जन को permanently बैठा दिया. You have gone down from 303 to 240. In my maiden speech in the Lok Sabha in June 2019, I spoke on the 7 signs of fascism that were taking over this country. 5 years to the date, on June 27, 2024, this House saw the unprecedented scene of the marshals welcoming the President of India, the Honorable President, with the Sengol in their hand. The Sengol is a symbol of the supreme authority of a monarch. It has no place in the temple of a constitutional democracy. But Honorable Speaker, sir, it is understandable why this happened. Because the BJP has still not understood that their 303 brute majority, their Raj Tantra, has been reduced to a 240 seat minority by the Lok Tantra. They are still living in the world of the Sengol. This sudden change reality, this new reality, is yet to sink in for the treasury benches and especially for the speech writers of the Honorable President's address. The speech that the Honorable President read out, she said, the people of India have elected a stable government with a clear majority. Please do not embarrass the office of the President by using poorly edited cut and paste versions of old speeches. This is not a stable government. It depends on multiple allies with a history of U-turns. It has not got a simple majority. The BJP is 32 short of 272. It is going to be a very hard landing for the Treasury benches, as was obvious today. This time, there are 234 warriors this time, firmly united, and we have walked through fire to walk through these doors, so you will not be able to shut us up this time the way you did last time. There are numerous statements in the Honorable President's address that defy even a tenuous link to truth and to reality. Like in my 2019 maiden speech when I spoke in 7 signs, today I have picked out 6 themes from the Honorable President's address and I will analyze how each of them is an exercise in fallacy and exercise in untruth. The address covers many issues, but I have chosen 6 themes. The first theme, the Northeast. The Honorable President's address says that the government has increased allocation for the Northeast by 4 times, has worked for increased and lasting peace in the area. Now, I have one question. Why is the word Manipur nowhere in the speech? Why do we refer to the generic Northeast? During the Lok Sabha campaign, the BJP, the ruling party, the Honorable Prime Minister mentioned many words beginning with the letter M. Musalman, Mullah, मदरसा, मुगल, मटन, मछली, मुजरा, मंगलसूत्र, but not once did they mention Manipur. We don't need to act east. The government says we want to act east. We don't need you to act east. Look east, walk east, and most important, embrace east. I stand here for my brothers and sisters of Manipur, and I quote the revolutionary poet Pablo Neruda. One morning the bonfires leapt out of the earth. One morning the bonfires leapt out of the earth, devouring human beings. And from then on the fire, from then on blood. Come, see the blood on the streets. Come, see the blood in the streets. Please go to Manipur, see the blood in the streets. The second theme in the president's address, women empowerment. The speech says, women in our country have been demanding greater representation in the Lok Sabha and Vidhan Sabhas, and today they stand empowered by the Women's Reservation Act. This is a complete untruth. Firstly, you conveniently delayed reservation for women in parliament because you actually fear women. Yes. You fear Nari Shakti. Yes. You want their support, but you certainly don't want us here. The 17th Lok Sabha had 78 women, 14.3%. The 18th Lok Sabha, this Lok Sabha, has only 74 women. Shit. 4 women less than last time, only 13.6%. The ruling party, the BJP, had called a special session to bring in the Women's Reservation Bill. They have got a shameful 30 women MPs out of 240, only 12.5%. It is only Mamata Banerjee's Trinamool Congress that in 2019 had 37%, and even this time has got 38%. The president's address talks of a comprehensive campaign by the government to enrich and make 3 crore women Lakhpati Didis. All that we have seen so far is a far more comprehensive campaign to make 1 Arabpati Dada. I'm sure I don't need to take his name in this house. I'm sure we all know who we are talking about. Yes.